Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Tuesday. This is The Crafty Cottage. I'm so glad that you're joining me today because I am working on my bullet journal. I have been bullet journaling for about 4 years now. And if you've been following along with me, you'll know that they were all stolen, which kind of sucks. So this is my bullet journal for this year. It is a Master Touch bullet journal that I got from Hobby Lobby. It is smaller than an A5. And then for my candle, I've got the hot cocoa and cream. And then I started filming this right before work, so I'm just drinking Sprite. And then just showing you all the various materials that I used. So the first thing that I did in my bullet journal was glue that first page down that's like partially glued so it's hard to use. And then the first page in my bullet journal is actually the grid spacing cheat sheet. This is made famous by Amanda Rage Lee, who is like the bullet journal queen. Which I will link her video down in the description where she explains this, but basically you just number the lines horizontally and then vertically, and then you figure out how many spaces it would take to divide your paper into 3 sections or 4 sections or however many that you plan to have. So the most common that I have is dividing my paper in half, in thirds, and in fourths. So that's what I'm doing here. I have all of them in different colors, so half is going to be red, and I think blue is thirds, and purple is fourths. This notebook is slightly smaller than an A5, so it's 31 spaces across and 46 spaces down. The halfway going across is the line between 15 and 16, and then the halfway going down is between 22 and 23. The thirds going across is 10 spaces, 10 spaces, and then 9 spaces because it's an odd number. And the fourths is 7 spaces all the way across. And then going down, the thirds are 15, 15, and 14. Again, just weird how that came out. And then the fourth is 11, 11, 11, and 10 on the spaces. So previously I would like get really into bullet journaling and then I'd stop because it would feel like a chore, and then I'd be like, oh well, I need to get back into bullet journaling, and then the cycle would just start all over. So I'm going to really try to use my journal but make it not a chore, if that makes sense. So like, I don't have habit trackers, I don't have mood trackers, I don't have like cliche things, because that's the thing about bullet journals, is they're supposed to be geared for you, not for Instagram, or not for what worked for that person or what works for this person. So I'm really trying to gear this one towards me. I just wanted to share it with you guys in case any of my spreads give you inspiration. So at the time of me doing this voiceover, I have penciled out my January spreads. I just haven't taken the time to do them or record them. But my January spreads will be coming out soon. I just don't know when, because work and all that stuff that life has for you. So the next page is my title page. I stopped recording so I could figure out what I wanted to do for it, and I kept it pretty basic, just put 2022 on there, with like these weird outliney things, and a couple sprigs of lavender, because as of late, lavender has been one of my favorite flowers. I think it's flowers. So then I did like faux calligraphy kind of thing on the letter, or numbers, those are numbers. And then I messed up that last two and was really mad about it. And then I filled it in with brush pen. Can you guys believe it's already 2022? Like, that's just crazy. I feel like it was 2015, not that long ago. So, I hope everyone's new year was good. Mine, honestly, was kind of boring. They're usually really fun, but I don't know. This year just wasn't great. We played some games, but the mood wasn't there, you know? So, now I am just going over the lavender that I drew with a fineliner. I'm using the Paper Studio fineliners that I got from Hobby Lobby. Mostly got these just because they were on sale, but they're actually pretty nice. It came in a pack of 7, I believe. Another reason that I chose to put lavender on my title page is because I wanted to use it throughout my bullet journal because I am getting married this year, and lavender is one of our flowers. So I really like how it looks, and it's really pretty. These little doodles took me forever to figure out, but after I figured them out, I keep drawing them everywhere. I've figured out how to draw them on my iPad too, so. Along with lavender being one of our colors, so is sage, which I don't really have a sage color marker, so I use the next best thing with that green to do that bordery thing. And now I am just taking my lavender colored super tip and coloring in the lavender. I did a quite sloppy job, but I did that on purpose because I keep seeing things like that where it's like outside the lines, and I just like how that looks. I think it's cute. Plus, the like petals are so small that you can't really see it. So, for these next couple spreads, they are my future logs. I see future logs everywhere. I think some people call them year at a glance also, but they're like the same thing. It's whatever. So, I based my future log off of two different YouTubers' bullet journals, one of them being Jenny at Prayers and Penguins, and the other one being Pickup Limes. So, Pickup Limes divides her pages vertically into three sections, 3 months per section, and it takes up 2 pages. She has the mini calendars up at the top, and then the numbers 1 through however many days are in that month going vertically down the column. And then we'll put whatever is happening that day next to the date. I've seen other people do this same layout, and the only really complaint that they've had is the lack of space on being able to write. Like, if you've got 2 things happening on one day, like, it'd be difficult to write both of them in the tiny space that you have. But I figured I'd try it out anyway. So now I'm just doing the last 6 months of the year. Are you guys doing a bullet journal? If you are, go ahead and let me know in the comments. And if you have a YouTube and you do bullet journaling, tell me your YouTube and tell me that you do that, because I just love, like, watching YouTube and BookTube videos. So a lot of the time I have a habit of like turning on a YouTube video and listening to it while I do other things. So like putting this video together, I didn't have any sound, so I was listening to other stuff. So I'll either listen to music or I'll turn on another YouTube video and just listen to it. Or if you recreate any of the spreads that I do have a hashtag that you can leave on your Instagram so I can see it. It is the Crafty Cottage Bujo. So now I am finishing up with the lines, and all I'm doing now is numbering 1 through however many days are in that month going vertically. So I kept messing up because there's those little spaces between all the columns that I meant to write the numbers in, and then I would remember to do them, and then I'd forget again. So there's only like 4 of them that the numbers are in the right spot. And then I also messed up, I can't remember if it's this one, no, it's this one. I messed these numbers up because I forgot the number 21, but I didn't catch it until I was working on the next month's numbers. doing these videos are always so complicated, like doing the voiceovers, because I always feel like I'm rambling, so then I try not to talk as much, but then like I'm not talking, so there's just silence. Then I don't know what to talk about, which is always complicated. So, sorry about it, I guess. I don't know if you noticed what I was talking about with writing inside the little lines between the columns, but I forgot, and it's only on the last two again. So I am just finishing up the numbers. It's a really long process, and I messed up again, but that's okay. Whiteout is your friend when you're bullet journaling. So I got these really cool clear stamps for Christmas. They've been on my Amazon wishlist for really long time, but so I just grabbed the Sunday through Saturday dates and then figured out which month was for January. And then I just go across and match the date with the little stamp, if that makes sense. This just makes it a whole lot easier, and then you're not writing the dates over and over and over again. So this is the part that I was inspired by Jenny from Prayer and Penguins, and she wrote the months in different colors corresponding to the season, which I thought was really cool. So the winter months are in blue, the spring months are in green, the summer months are in yellow, and then the fall months are in orange. So yeah, I thought that was really cool. And then it also adds a little bit more color to these spreads, because I've been doing pretty minimalistic spreads as of late. I used to be really, really like into the fancy and creative ones, but since my bullet journals got stolen, I just haven't been into it as much. So my next spreads are my goal spreads, which I guess is just one spread taking up two pages. So I wrote down various goals that I wanted, and I believe in my most recent bullet journal, my goal spread looked kind of like this one. It's just boxes, and then I write the goals inside the boxes. So I think I had 9 goals altogether. And I broke a few of them down, like, to see how I'm progressing in those goals, which are the ones that I put on here. So I'm just writing goals, attempting to do it kind of pretty, but, yeah, whatever. So for the first goal on here, it's to read 30 books. Last year I had a goal to read 10, and I passed that, so then I changed it to 25. I think. So I'm just upping it by 5. As of recording this video, I had 283 subscribers, but as of today, I have 300, so woohoo! I just uploaded a video about a giveaway that I'm doing. So I would like to, by the end of the year, have 500 subscribers, so here is where I can track that, and I'll just color over the number when I get to that many subscribers. Same thing with the books. When I hit that many books, I'll just color over that number. So another goal is to pray more through the good and the bad, to read 10 books of the Bible. I had the same goal last year, but I didn't meet it, so I would like to try it again. I'm hoping, because Bible Book Club was started, that I'll actually be able to get this one all the way through, because it was started in May, I believe, of last year, so that's not gonna equal out to 10 books altogether, so we'll see how it goes. Hope I can get all 10 read, or maybe more. And then I have a goal to lead my youth group one time a semester. These semesters coincide with my music group with the church, so it's easier for me to track. And then I have another goal to try something new every month. Anybody that knows me knows I hate trying new things, so I would like to try at least one new thing every month. And then another one to blog twice a month. I stopped blogging because, again, it started feeling more like a chore, and then also, like, life and everything just kept getting in the way. So, gonna try to reboot that and blog twice a month for you guys. So my next spread I actually messed up. So the sticky note says books read, but I actually ended up doing book recommendations and series recommendations. So on the left is book recommendations, and then on the right is series recommendations. In my most recent bullet journaling video thing, I think I did like two whole pages per each of these, but then I didn't even really write that many into them, so I gave them one page each this time, and if I need more, I can always add another page later in the bullet journal. But if you guys have any book or series recommendations, leave them in the comments below, and I will definitely put them in these spreads. So they're both pretty much the same layout. They have three columns: book, author, and who it's recommended by, or series, author, and who it's recommended by. Currently not filled out at all, so if you have any, please leave them in the comments. I guess I can use right now to tell you guys my book recommendation or series recommendation for you guys. It is the Bone Season series by Samantha Shannon. I am currently on book number 3, which is The Song Rising, but I can't find anywhere to like get it other than Amazon. So might have to break down and buy me a new book, or just wait, but I would really like to read it soon. Anyway, that's my series recommendation for you guys. It is so good. It's set in the future. It's a dystopian novel. It's about clairvoyant people, and it's like illegal. I think I've talked about it in a recent video. I'll put it up in the little corner thing and down in the description for whatever month I read those and talked about it in my TBR game. As I'm finishing up these spreads, I can tell you guys that I went to Barnes & Noble and got a few new books for finishing my goal last year of reading 10 books. I got Malamander, which is actually on my TBR this month. I got Assassin's Apprentice by Robin Hobb, and the first installment of the Ruby manga, because we have been watching the shows trying to catch up, because I think there's another season coming out soon. So this next spread is actually the one that was supposed to be on the last pages. It's the books that I've read, and I just kept the same layout from my previous bullet journal that I had at the end of 2021. It has 5 sections. There's title, author, when I started it, when I finished it, and the rating that I gave it. And then I'm going to leave the next page blank for more books that I've read in case I read more than however many spaces are there, or if I just decide to do something else with that page. So currently it's blank. But we'll see what happens with it. So I didn't get to draw Lavender throughout my setup spreads, but I did keep the theme of the lavender color and the dark green throughout all of my spreads. So at least there's that. There's some coherentness going on. That lavender marker is running out of ink and it looks terrible. I do have another one. I really just need to buy more markers. So the next spread is books of the Bible, and this I am just drawing out 66 boxes and then putting the abbreviated version of the title of all the books that are in the Bible, and then I will color the square whenever I read that book. So currently I have 7 books read. This has been since Bible Book Club started last May. I've only not finished once, I think, and that was Leviticus, and that's because it's really hard to read. So I think I mentioned previously that I was filming this right before work, So once I finished drawing all 66 boxes, I stopped and blew out the candle and went and got ready for work, and then worked, and then didn't come back to my bullet journal for a couple days, actually, because I kept having to work.
1 eternity later.
Alright, so now I'm back. I'm relighting my same candle, but this time I have coffee because it's early in the morning and I am in the process of finishing setting up my bullet journal. So now I am just writing all of the books in the squares so I know which one's which. Eventually I will have this memorized if I write it in a bullet journal enough times. Plus, you can see down in the lower left-hand corner, that is my cheat sheet because I have written the books of the Bible down several times and still don't have it completely memorized. So, we'll see if that ever happens. My cheat sheet is actually in my faith journal, and I've thought about doing a little flip-through of that for you guys, so if you're interested, please let me know in the comments. This next spread is for Bible Book Club. I am the most organized person there, so I'm always in charge of texting everybody and reminding them that we're meeting and what books we're reading and blah blah blah. So this is going to be my tracker for the year to basically remember what books we've read. So I have three columns. The first one is the month. The middle one is what books we're reading, and then on the video, the last column is if I finished it or not, but I'm actually going to wipe that out, and the last column is going to be the date that we are meeting, so I can just refer back to that when I go to text everybody, and then I can also look back later and be like, yes, we did read this book, or this is the month that we read this book, or blah blah blah. This will also help when we decide to change when we're going to meet. For example, at the end of October, we decided for November that we were going to read Judges and the first 10 Psalms. I'm recording this voiceover on January 4th, and I can tell you that we still have not met to talk about Judges and the first 10 Psalms. I believe we're going to be meeting this Saturday, which this video should be up by then, but this spread will help me to basically see the date that we're meeting. So this next page, I sped up really, really fast because I did it and then didn't know what I was going to do with it. Basically, I wanted to do something with it that tracked my youth group and music through the church, but I don't actually know what I was using it for, so there's that. This next page is studies that I want to do. So the only one that I have on there right now is Ruth. But I just put studies to do and put a cute border on it. And then I actually later went back and put in, like little check boxes so I could write down the studies that I wanted to do and then mark them off as I did them. And then this next page is something I've done in a lot of other bullet journals since doing YouTube, but it is video ideas. So I put the YouTube logo in the middle, and it's basically like a brain dump kind of thing. So anywhere on the page, I'll just write ideas for videos that I have. And that's pretty much it for that page. This next page is actually one that I found on YouTube by Lu Tang Studio, I think. I'll link her down in the description. But she did a video on bullet journals for students, and I think I previously mentioned I got accepted into grad school, so I'm going to have to be tracking school things again. So this page is just my schedule. I'm only taking two classes, so I didn't need to make like a whole big thing where I blocked out the time that the classes were.
And I'm also doing this program completely online, so the schedule is really not important. This is basically just saying what classes I have, and it has the class, the date range, the dates that we are meeting, because I think there are going to be some Zoom classes, and the time, if there is a time, the professor, and the professor's email. And then the next page is also from the same person on YouTube. It was in the same video, and it is a semester log. So it is very similar to a future log, except it's only covering the semester. So I divided these two pages into six different sections. My first semester is January to May, which is 5 months. So I am just putting the calendar on the side and then the month that it corresponds to above it. And then I color-coded my classes, so one class is going to be light green and the other one's going to be pink. And I'm going to use this basically the same way you would use a future log, which is just a place where you can see where things are due and how long you have to do them. So yeah, it's basically just something to help me keep track of homework and assignments that I have to do. And then I went ahead and marked the start of the semester and the end of the semester in the colors that I've been using throughout the entire bullet journal so far. These next two pages are the last pages that I made for the video. I do actually have a couple more that I made after I finished recording, but I'll share those with you in my January setup. So these two are my pen pal and artist trading card tracking sheets, I guess. So it's going to be where I track when I have a pen pal letter come in or when I have artist trading cards come in, and it's divided into four columns on both sides, and it's got the name of whoever sent it to me, when I received it, if I responded, and it when the date that I sent the thing back. So that's all the spreads that I have for you. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell to be notified when I post again. And hopefully I will see you guys Saturday with another video. Also, stay tuned for a video talking about pen paling and artist trading cards. I actually have quite a few of those coming out soon, so stay tuned for those. And don't forget to enter in the giveaway that I'm currently hosting. Here is a final flip through of my 2022 bullet journal setup. I will see you guys later. Bye!